seem to be evasive.
As I go to prose, not very good poetry necessarily, but still in some, with some kind of rhythm. So a lot of them I didn't have to do that for. I mean, Private was an example of one that was written just like that.
The song to and about your mother. I knew about it before I heard it. And then when I heard it, it was not sorrowful. And it was not sad. It was, in fact, upbeat and affirming.
I'll wait no more for you. Like a daughter, that part of our life together is over. But I will wait for you forever. Like a river.
About a week after she died, and I had had an experience that I think a lot of people have when a parent or somebody very close dies, a feeling that they're still around and that you can still talk to them. It's about being in the conversation with her still, that the conversation never really ends. It does go on. And I wanted to find out things about what happens when you're over there on the other side. I asked, do you know any more about God? Are you dancing with Benjamin Franklin, who was her favorite historical figure, mm-hmm. on the face of the moon?
Will you reconcile with Dad?
Does the rain still make you sad?
Are there bunches of songs in you still?
You know, every day is a song, if I wanted to, if I was that dedicated, if I was that... disciplined, I could write a song every day. I mean, they wouldn't all be good, but I see a day's events in terms of a song. Mm. And I feel emotionally about so many things, and as long as there's an emotional drive, that's sort of the motor for a song beginning.
Yeah. What kind of a song is today?
Today is a song about samovars and Russian colors and about how pre-revolutionary days and the mood can be brought into